Made by Ryan Christopher on IG. I just reached out to him and I'm like, dude.
That's funny. My middle name is Christopher.
Is it really?
Yeah.
So I reached out to him like, dude, can you make me a little funky ass beat? Because, you know, Ryan, you got the cool intro.
Yeah.
We got the intro. We've got the Justice
League. I like it. That sounded good.
That'd be pretty cool. So, yeah, we're just waiting. All right. The Source Supreme is on. What's up, brother?
Are we live?
We are live and kicking right now.
Oh, shit. I'm late then. What
up? We haven't officially started yet. So we're all just here chilling. So, Roger's got some. We got a little music we're gonna play before we get started.
I'm properly medicated, so I'm good.
25 years ago today, we found out what G-Funk was. This album dropped
25 years ago.
It was a make you feel old. So I can get some phones rolling in my ride, chilling out the clouds. Just hit the east side of the LBC. It's the world in jeans. You can fall full of girls, ain't no need to tweak. All you search for what's up here, 213. So I hook select. Only these dogs, you died of cancer.
Really?
Yeah.
So I said, let's do this. Such a cancer.
Yeah, it's a
some brothers. And now we got Mr. Comics 89. We got Discovery Bay. We got Fair Island. We got Dave DeCuna, Mr. 98. So let's go play a little funky music right now.
Copyright ding.
No, I'm definitely getting copyright ding on this. It seems to be like,
you know what? Just don't monetize it. Turn the monetization off.
We're not making
anybody. It'll be fine.
I'll talk to Warren G. I'll be like, yo, man, let it slide for a man's birthday. You only
try. We'll give him a free book.
Yeah, we'll give him a free book. All right. Yeah. So let's see. We got some dudes online right now. We're all here together. So what is up, everybody? Welcome to 3 Men in the Basement. The birthday bash special, CGC unraveling, a reveal, and the superpowers collide. So I am Otto from 3 Men in the Basement. I'm your host. We also have my co-host, Mr. Roger Levesque. Say what's up to everybody.
What's up, everybody? Peace. Thanks for joining us.
All right. Straight out of Jersey, we have the variant whore, Nemesis Prime, joining us tonight in the grotto.
What's up, everybody?
Live.
All right. Now, the superpowers collide. This is like when Macho Man and Hulk Hogan come together, right? This is it, you know? So we do have my brothers from Lords of the Long Box. We have Darkside Jedi, the executive producer. My man, I'm happy to have you here tonight.
Yeah, yo, brother. How you doing? I'm glad to be here, brother.
Thank you very much for coming. And for the first time in the grotto, straight from the West Coast, the Source Supreme himself, Mr. TiVo. Thank you very much for coming in tonight, brother.
What up? Let me pop my collar. What's craggy-lagging, yo?
That's all right. That's what we want to do. Pop collar.
It's a little bit too hot to actually wear the cloak today because it's like fucking 80 degrees in this bitch.
You wonder what he really did when it was really hot out. So I like that. The cloak, right? The cloak of levitation.
Yeah, I don't got any pants on either. So you got that.
Neither do I, but that's okay. So anyway, so what we're going to do is we got a few things we want to talk about. We got a lot of stuff going on. Discovery Bay, Bear Island, you know, some people. Thanks a lot for jumping in with us. We do have our 500 sub giveaway, a winner. We got three winners. We're going to do that. We got lots of polls. We got Ryan chopping at the bit.
Yeah.
And we're going to talk a little bit about some comic news. So, but the first thing we like to do when we have somebody new to the grotto like TiVo is find out what is his huspa, right? What did he start collecting? You know, what was the first thing he started collecting? Huspa is a thing. It's a thing, right?
It's a thing. Forget about it.
So, TiVo, what is the first thing you ever remember collecting, bro? Like, what is, like, you remember going to the store, buying? Like, tell me about it.
Well, that's an interesting story, actually. Right. The first thing I read ever, or at least tried to read, or at least went through and looked at the pictures, was Spider-Man. I was probably like in second grade. We had like a friend of family. He used to like he was going to law school, and he was renting out one of the rooms in our apartment. And he would buy Spider-Man books, and he'd let me read them afterwards. And this was like, God, late 70s,
okay,
right. First thing I started collecting, I remember to this very day, I bought it off the shelf, was X-Men, either 169 or 170. It was like a 50-cent book. I bought it at 7-Eleven.
Yeah.
It had Wolverine on the cover. It was the wedding picture with Wolverine America. I bought that, and after that, I was hooked. And the story, well, I've told the story before, but actually, so I didn't have tons of money. So it was like in fifth grade, our bus that used to pick us up, right, was right in front of a 7-Eleven. So what I do is we go to that 7-Eleven, we play like, you know, this is back when every 7-Eleven had a video game, right? Yeah, we would play, and I used to play the Atari stand up version, the Vector. Yeah. Based game, right? I used to kill that shit, by the way. And so what I would do is sometimes I'd buy comics, but the spinner rack was toward the back where the video games was. What I do is I'd put my binder in there. And you know, there's a lot of people 7-Eleven in the morning buying breakfast, coffee, and shit. So what I do is I'd grab like one or two comics and I put it inside my binder and I close it. And I just walk out. Dude, eventually I had like 50 books. And back then I couldn't even afford a long box, right? You know, because you know, when you're a kid, you don't have boxes or anything. I was just, and they were stacking up. And I remember I was getting all kinds of weird titles, but X-Men got me hooked. I bought like All-Star Squadron number one, Blue Beetle number one. But X-Men is what I started buying, what I started collecting first. Like X-Men, when I remember first going into a comic store and buying back issues to complete my run. Was John Byrne's Fantastic Four run.
Perfect, right, absolutely.
Starting, I remember it was already up in the 250s, 260s, so I had to go all the way back. I had a mentor who taught me how to, he had an amazing Fantasy 15. I didn't know what it was back then. He goes, look, this is the first time. Big fucking dude, man. It's only got, it only costs 15 cents on the cover, right?
Oh my God.
So, but then, and one of the books that what I consider a wall book was What If Number One. Because when I first walked into a comic shop in like sixth grade, I was like, ooh, What If Number One? 7-Eleven? So it's interesting back then, dude. Like, I had a couple of comic shops, but I had to, like, we had to ride our bikes. And, you know, that means it was like 5 miles away. Right. Or take a bus.
I would buy it from like the newsstand and stuff like that.
But it was interesting. There were some liquor stores that had like stuff that wasn't what you would see in a normal newsstand. Like Marvel Universe, the encyclopedia, basically the Marvel Universe 1 through 12. Yeah. I first saw that at a liquor store. I was like, what is this? I've never seen this in my 7-Eleven before.
So,
this is where I started. I still have the Marvel Universe books, and that X-Men 170, 169 is still in my collection.
That's a phenomenal book. I know exactly the cover. That's Claremont. And was it J.R. John Romita Jr. did that, I think? I don't know.
Yeah, that was the whole Wolverine Miracle Wedding that obviously turned out bad for Wolverine. Yes. That's what got me kind of hooked into X-Men. Yeah.
Pretty good. So now we like my collection, I sold off a chunk of them. I don't really remember. Like, this is kind of like your second collection of books, right? Like, didn't you say, you know, you sold some books and now you're like, you got it again?
So I started collecting like in the fifth, sixth grade, all the way up to like junior high and high school. But then I started getting, you know, I was peer pressure. I was hanging out with, you know, I was in the hood with I was caught up in the G life in Cali, man. You were either a nerd or a gangster. So in our neighborhood, we had a thing. And so I was kind of like going to comic shops on Wednesday by myself. I didn't want to be known, be seen as a nerd and shit. Right. Even though I needed glasses, I never got glasses. I didn't want to be a nerd. Now I'm like, shit, I'm blind as fuck. But, you know, some of the homies were digging comics too, and we all were like, fuck it, you know. And then I remember, like, in high school, we used to get stoned and hang out with dudes that were playing D&D.
Because
we used to get high, like, since like eighth grade.
Hey, that's fun. Weed. That game is fun, man.
Yeah. So we were like, you know what? This D&D shit is trippy as hell when you're high, man. Let's get with these fucking nerds and play some of this Dungeons and Dragons. And we also play Gamma World, you know, back then. While we're still doing graffiti on the walls, we would fucking play D&D. So it was like a weird little thing. That was my first collection, and then I started up again in like the right around when eBay was coming out in like 2000s, right? This is when the Wild Wild West of eBay. You had to mail somebody a fucking money order.
Yes. Oh my Once God. You had to go to
post office. Receive the money order. They would mail you a comic book and shit. It was sometimes it'd be folded in half. And that I remember right then I was chasing. That was when Ultimate Spider-Man came out. And that was a super hot title.
Yep.
And then prior to that, in the 90s, I got what I really started chasing was when Witchblade number one came out. I remember driving around to comic book shops all over the Bay Area to look for Witchblade number one. And that was like the height of my addiction, I think, was right in the 90s. It's kind of like everybody else.
We call that the fever, right? You're like caught up. Yeah. You got to get enough and stuff like that. So
you want to talk about the fever? When I first started, it was I was in my late 30s.
Right, right.
And
disposable income, right?
I had disposable income. My first purchase was a 12 long box collection.
Was it really?
And that's where I started because I started watching all you guys on YouTube.
Right. Yeah, Ryan started buying like fucking Golden Age Batmans off the bat. And
it was crazy. Right, exactly. It was crazy.
Going big, tail, you know. Very bit of bold, you know.
So, well, yeah. I did a mail order. I took a chance on that Batman number two.
Yes, right.
It was an eBay purchase that we did offline. I sent a certified check in the mail to this person, sight unseen. Okay. I took a chance. You know, sometimes you got to gamble in life and it paid off.
Nice. So,
that's awesome. Man, why don't I have a wrench?
The moderator, I haven't figured out how to do that yet. I'm still moving.
Yeah, you just click on my name next to the three dots, and
I want
you
one too, man.
Yeah, you guys are all be moderators. Yeah,
what's up with that, man?
I'll make everybody moderators. We're all here.
Messed up, man.
So,
as your birthday present, you should give us all wrenches.
Yes, you guys will all be wrenches, right? Absolutely.
Thank you.
So I really that's what's cool because we talk about everything we had, and when everybody comes on, we just want to see what they got collected and stuff like this. But listen, so Ryan's got some books that we've been talking about on Lores. We've been talking about three men. We're going back and forth. He finally has some books in from C2E2, Teen Titans book, DC books that he's been waiting on. And typical 3 Men in the Basement fashion is we wait on our books, right?
I've never done this before.
Right.
I've never waited this long. I'm sweating. My right. hands are clammy.
Yes, absolutely.
How is that different from any other show?
So what we want to do is we want to find out, first of all, you've got some books in here. It's going to be kind of hard to do because you're solo, but could you just go over the books and a little bit of history about them and, you know, get an idea of where we're
at? Yeah, I mean, if you're a DC collector, you should know they're very, what can I say, well-known, I guess.
Yeah.
So it's DC Comics Presents number 26.
Yeah.
That's the first appearance of the new Teen Titans. It was new Teen Titans number 2, first appearance of Deathstroke.
One of my favorite ever.
So that book was, those two books were already graded.
Yeah.
The DC Comics Presents 26 was a 9.6 CGC. And the New Teen Titans 2 was a 9.4 CBCS.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
The other three were two Teen Titans number ones, New Teen Titans number ones, and one New Teen Tales of the New Teen Titans 44, which is first Nightwing.
Right, of course. So those are all the heavy hitters.
And those were raw.
Right.
I sent them to Rocket Comics out there in California. Comics. Great, great. If you need pressing, if you need, well, I know you guys have your own pressing guy, but not to step on anybody's toes, but
of course. No, we've got Rocket.
He did a fantastic job. His people are great. Melissa with the customer service, brilliant. She'll get back to with you very quickly when you have questions. They facilitated the signatures. And so I sent my books to their booth at C2E2, and they got me a double signed George Perez, Marv Wolfman signature on all of these books.
Let's do it.
So we're going to see what happens.
Right. And they came in the mail yesterday.
They came in the mail.
Let's say Friday.
They came in the mail Wednesday.
Right.
I wasn't home. I had them hold it at the post office, and I went and picked them up yesterday at the post office.
So before you get started, if you're enjoying my birthday, we're hanging out the night before. You got a drink in your hand. You're drinking your glass. Do. Cheers, you guys. Thanks, everybody, joining us.
Cheers.
Thanks for joining us.
I am really excited about this, you guys.
Absolutely. This is pretty good.
So now. I'm nervous, though, too, because a 9.6 is a good grade. But that's hope for that karate chop. Like, that, like, this, like that, that they chop. Like to say,
we,
and the Three Men in the Basement.
Yeah.
Otto Grotto.
That's right. We want to get that in. So you've been holding on to, but you prepped him today. He's ready to go. So let's see it, Justin. Let's go.
I'm ready. I'm ready. Okay. So I'm not Justin. I'm Ryan.
Sorry, you're right. Ryan, I'm all fired up.
Staring at me. I'm going to get a 9-8. That's usually the idea.
All right. All right. I'm not even going to look. I'm just going to hold them up.
Okay.
I'm going to take them out of their little.
Click the screen on Ryan so it stays on him.
All right.
Good. Let me know when I'm ready.
Yeah.
All right. You ready? So here is New Teen Titans. Holy shit. What?
Whoa.
What?
Whoa. That's a beast. Oh,
that is a.
Lower it a little, Ryan. There you go. Lower it.
Yeah, lower it. Lower. There you go.
That's a gut punch.
That's
what were you expecting?
It was a 9.6 graded. It was a slab 9.6.
Wow.
Slab 9.6.
Was it a new label or old label originally?
It was a blue new label.
Did you touch that book?
I didn't touch it.
You didn't touch that
book? I didn't look at it.
Ouch.
God damn, Ryan. My bad, bro.
Maybe this is the luck I've been.
Well,
I mean, sometimes one of those
old motherfuckers finger fucked it.
Yep.
Yeah. Right. Right.
You know what? It's double signed.
Mars big palm.
Put yeah. It, or
made a crease.
You know that same guy you got on a Friday night.
Yeah.
I've got two more raw DC-26s to send in, and you maybe really? We can. Yeah, we'll get it. We'll get it going. We'll see if we can get a 9.8 out of one of those.
Well, they're going
to
be a Terrificon, I think. Are they both going to be a Terrificon?
Yeah.
Marv. Yeah. So I can help with that if you want me to. Terrificon. Right. I can't wait. Shout out to Mitch Halleck and everybody at Terrificon. Who do we got? We got Very Gary in the live chat. Who else we got? Yeah. We got JLS.
Ryan, I would actually contact CGC and ask them for a regrade. That is a significant drop.
Okay. Okay.
But it's hard to say since, since it's double signed, they can say, hey, you know, handling and whatnot. But that's
right.
Rather precipitous drop.
That really is. I'm very shocked. I'm very shocked.
That's like three grades.
No, I'm very shocked. I'm gonna start drinking more.
That's
cool. So here's Tales of the New Teen Titans 44.
Yep, I like that grade.
This was raw.
Yep.
So I could deal with this. I like it. It's solid. Double sign.
Iconic book. That's a nice book right there.
All right.
All right.
Next up.
All right.
This is Teen Titans number one. This was raw.
Ooh.
Another 8.5. So hey, linear.
Linear. There you go. Teen Titans keys that are linear.
Yep, there
double
you go.
Side. We like linear. Double side. Yep. Double label. Yep. Same grade. Boom.
There you go. All right. This is the other Teen Titans number one.
That was raw.
This was raw. Yep.
No, this is the two. I like this one.
There you go.
9.2.
There you go. I could deal with that.
Yep.
9.2. Like that. Makes me happy.
Yep.
All right. Now, Jesus Christ, I'm nervous. This one might be I got a feeling in my stomach, you guys. All right, this was the 9.4 CBCS.
Uh-oh. We can go either way, actually.
Let's talk about this. 9.4 CBCS.
Uh-huh.
Let's talk about this.
What book is it?
It's a New Teen Titans number two. First
okay, yellow, it's a yellow right. book.
And it was a CBCS 9.4.
9.4.
Yep.
I'm going to say it's a 9.6.
9.6, really?
Yeah, I
okay, so Tim and Rogers think the
after
same.
Seeing a 9.6 go to a 9.0,
yeah,
you're gonna say 9.6.
Yeah. I'm gonna say 9.6.
I'm gonna say 9.4. Justin,
I think it stays at a 9.4.
Yeah, 9.4. All right.
Fuck, man. Okay.
Ryan melt live.
You might see me cry. A grown man cry.
We saw that a couple weeks ago.
We saw a grown man cry.
All right. Here we go, everybody. Right. New Teen Titans number two.
Boom.
All right.
Boom. Told you.
Oh, no. This is number one.
Wow. That's a different book.
This is number one.
I said 9.6 regardless. I don't care.
Oh, the 9.2.
Sorry. The 9.2 is an 8.5. Okay. New Teen Titans number one.
9.6. There you go. All right.
That's a good one.
So that was a 9.4.
No. This was.
That was a raw dog?
Oh, wait. Holy shit. Wait. I didn't even realize that. Wait a minute.
I'm confused, man.
That was the 9. Which one was the 9.4?
Okay, I'm confused. What just happened?
Well, one of them was a 9.4 that dropped. It took a big drop.
So wait, you had two of them, right?
I did.
And what grades were they both?
Yeah.
Okay. This is the Teen Titans. This is the correct one. So this is the 9.2. This was a 9.4.
Oh, all right.
So the 9.4 dropped to a 9.2. And 9.6 was a what?
Was raw.
Well, there you go. That's fucking nice, right?
So that was nice. 9.6
double signed all day long, man.
That was good. That was a good one. That's so hey, we got two out of five that are okay. Unbelievable. Hey, they all can't be winners, but I will call CGC this Monday and have a little conversation because that happened to you, Tim, didn't it?
Yeah.
Where you had a book that came back substantially lower, you sent it back and they fixed it, right? Or they reevaluated it and it was able to get fixed. Can you hear?
No, he's on the phone.
Oh.
Making deals.
Go ahead. What?
Your book. You
I'm saying that book that happened to you, you had a book submitted. It was substantially lower. You contacted them.
Yeah. Mine were not. Yeah. I actually had, in my favor, I actually still had the old labels.
Okay.
So what had happened was, I remember it was a dude that I posted it on the Facebooks, and some dude reached out to me, and I was like pissed off. I'm trying to think, man. I think it was something to do with Iron Fist. It could have been the first Sabretooth or something, or Iron Fist number one, and it came back a whole grade lower, like
whole grade.
Yeah, a whole grade. Like from no, it was now I remember it was X-Men 100 went from 9 to 8. And another book, they both dropped a whole grade, and I posted it on Facebook, and I was like, man, this is some bull crap, blah blah blah. This is right around CGC. I remember there was a whole buzz about them getting they contracted a bunch of new graders.
There will definitely be a Instagram post about this, ladies and gentlemen. Plus these were pressed.
Yeah,
so there's no excuse.
I still had the old labels though, so I was able to show proof that hey man, it came back a whole grade. I understand, you know, point whatever. And then some dude sent me a PM on Facebook saying, hey, send it back, you know, attention me, and we'll get the head grader to relook at them, you know, because you know, a lot of people in the CGC forums at the time were complaining because they had just the word was they just hired a bunch of contract graders. Right. And so they both came back. One came back the same grade I submitted it, and one came back like it was a 9.2, and it came back a 9.0. So I was happy. If I go back onto my Instagram, I'll find it and I'll tell you guys, because I made enough noise on social media to where, you know, they finally said, and there's, you know, to CGC's credit, this one dude reached out to me and he was like, hey, we'll regrade it for you. And this is the one time where it actually works. So it is an avenue, but you make sure you have evidence or something like that. So anytime I crack it, I always, dude, I have a stack of old labels. Here's one right here. I just laying around. You know, there's an Uncanny X-Men 266, 9.6. I always keep them if they get cracked. So if I ever had disputed it.
Notes lately.
Yeah.
And books that I've been looking at and stuff. So
yeah, greater notes are easy to buy, man. $10.
Yeah, no, I'll get them.
Doesn't have to be yours. And this is also a good way to tell you if
or you know, actually Rocket can get it. I mean, Rocket has them. I can get them. Yeah.
That's it. Well, it happened. So Ryan's just busted his nut. He got his books out. He was ready.
I mean, I'm sorry to disappoint. I'm a party pooper, you guys. I got to apologize. That was not intentional. I thought we were going to rock it out.
Yeah, Roger, I was going to get. It's not only me.
Finally, somebody else Roger gets screwed over by CGC.
Hey, you know what? It's that goddamn Michigan hat you're wearing.
Okay.
It's jinxing me.
Yeah. So what I was really thinking was, we could just go through, do the raffle right now. So we hit, we did hit our 500.
503?
503, right?
We're up to 503. Congratulations,
by the way. A little technical difficulties right now, but I'm rolling. So I took all 18 names of people. Now they got them in here. So really what I think the best thing to do is on Instagram, guys, DM me on Instagram. And then I will, your addresses when we pull the winners. And then I'll get the books out to you, okay? So we have three winners, right? And we're going to start with third place, all right? So the third place winner is going to receive this Sum-Sum. Number one, which is a variant, and it was a book that I picked up when I went to Disney World. So it's got the Disney World logo on it, exclusive to Disney World. So Roger, you're not gonna be able to read my handwriting, but tell us who our first winner is.
I'm just gonna dump these out because I can't really shake them up.
Yeah,
because it's a little cup.
I thought about using random.org, but I definitely don't know.
All right, so
like that here. Okay. So our first winner for the Sum-Sum is Mad24. So Mad24 on YouTube. Congratulations.
Congratulations.
You hit me up and find me on Instagram, Everett_Otto, and I'll get that out to you. I don't want to lose that. The next winner is going to receive I hate to see these go, but I've got another round of it. These are three books, variants, right? The theme of this is that they're all variants, which is pretty good. So especially when we have the variant whore in the house. So the first one we're going to go with is Defenders number one. This is the trade dress, the Del Otto book, right? Pretty cool, you know, in here in the grotto, Del Otto, Otto. Love it. We keep it together. Then we have the Virgin, which is right here, which looks really, really cool. And then the third one in the book is the black and white sketch. So really the third one, the second place winners really make it out on this one. So
you
get all of those, man. You get all of those. Because we got to keep it a set, right? I can't break them up. That's not linear. You got to keep them up. All right, so our second place winner and our 500 sub giveaway is Michael Rowe. All right, Michael Rowe, congratulations. You're our second place winner. DM me on Instagram. I'll get this out to you probably by Monday. So look for it next week because this weekend is a little bit busy with your boy's birthday. So very excited for everybody coming in with us. Okay, now the final winner is a slab. All right.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, it's a slab. It's a variant. It's a 9.0. It was a giveaway to me, so I'm going to pass it on to somebody else. And it's Generations number one, pink label, signed by Matina, 9.0. Justin, what's the history behind this book?
So that's a second print. The second printings were all done by Francesco Matina. This one is signed by Francesco Matina. It's the verified signature. So, you know, not authenticated through CBCS, but it is signed by him and it is rated. So still a cool book, you know. You're looking for a nice Cantina book.
Yeah,
I definitely like the book because it's got Laura Kinney on it, and it's got.
Hey, it's free. They shouldn't be complaining at all. Fuck them. Take what they get and say thank you very much.
Oh, Roger, who's our grand prize winner? There we go. Who is this? Oh, this is a cool one. BXPR Collector. BXPR Collector, thank you very much. You are our winner for this slab.
Congratulations.
Congratulations. Thank you very much for everybody. We're just going to keep going up. You know,
if I may, can I give a negative shout out to Deadpoolica Instagram, who's never in our live chat, but he's in your live chat. So that's a negative shout out to him. That's like a reverse shout out.
Right. Deadpoolica's joining us. All right. There we go. Stay Puff. We got Stay Puff on with us. Barry Gary's holding it down. Silver Age Dave. Oh, that's a great name. All right. So there we go with the raffle wins. Now it's time to turn it over to my co-host. He's got some books. He's been making some moves.
I haven't bought books in such a long time.
I know. You haven't bought books. You've been on a freeze, right?
I have been buying a couple books and had them slabbed, and they came back screwed by CGC.
Right. That was the sour taste.
I couldn't even look at them. I had to sell them. I had to sell them.
Oh, yeah. All these books will be for sale. Contact Dark Side Jedi on Instagram.
Yeah. There you go. Plug it in.
And Chromium is Harley Quinn number 6. Batman 66 variant. I love these. I love the old Joker. What's better than the old Batman 66 Joker?
Right. I love Cesar Romero. It was the first Joker. You know, I'll put him up against to anyone. I don't know what you guys think about him, who your favorite Joker was. Roger, who was your favorite Joker?
It's definitely
Heath Ledger?
Yeah, Heath Ledger. Yeah, there you definitely.
Go. I'm partial to Jack.
Jack.
I would say Jack, but I mean, as far as the cover, I mean, it's great because it's got the, you know, the little mustache that he had.
He refused to shave it.
Oh, 100%. So, I mean, it's classic because it still has him right on the cover.
Right on the cover. It, so. Yeah. Justin, who's your favorite Joker? I'm sorry, Ryan.
Oh, I would have to say Heath Ledger is my favorite Joker.
Okay, there you go. Yeah. All right. None of us said our
book. Love for Joaquin Phoenix? Come on, now. Really.
I haven't seen him yet. You can't. How can you judge on a trailer?
He's Batman's gotta see the movie. Brother, for God's sake. Come on now.
Yeah.
Let me see. Bam! Break it.
I hope I do. I hope Joaquin is my favorite. I hope this movie kills.
Yes, absolutely.
Next one is Zombie Trump number one. ASN 300 cover swipe. I mean...
No political things.
As a matter of fact,
you know what? To be fair, the Talon was Batman's brother.
Not only did I buy the Republican, I also bought the Democrat.
You need to get the green copy.
Yeah, right. Really, the Green Party. The
Green Party.
So, for those who don't know, I collect ASM 300 cover swipes.
What the fuck is that, man?
So, with these two and the other one I'm going to show, I'm up to a 50.
That is horrifying.
Wait, yeah, you said you collect.
That's ASM pretty naughty.
300 cover swipe.
ASM 300 cover swipes.
I have a ASM 300 cover swipe.
It would be a chrome one.
It could be a chrome one.
Let's raffle that off tonight.
$10 a ticket. No raffles. No raffles for that. I'm going to be procuring that book from you after the show at some point.
All right.
And so this just is came really in. Dope. I love this. They have different colors. I do have the white one of this, but I like this one because it looks most like the ACM-300 Lady Death cover swipe. The green one is I'm pretty sure is the most expensive. Right.
But it's number 666.
Yes, it's shoe number 666. I
know someone that would like that.
I didn't realize when I got it on eBay that it has a signature, which actually pisses me off because I wanted to submit it because it's definitely a 9.8 candidate. Right. I have an actual ASM-300 9.8. This would have been beautiful next to it, but now it'll come back with Mark.
Look at Lady Death's crotch on that cover. It looks like it's her ass, not her hoonanny.
Yeah. Look at that. Right. That's a great cover.
Yeah. One's close enough to the other.
If you were British, you'd call that a fanny.
A fanny. A fanny.
All right.
If you're a comic book fanatic, you would call that a tranny. Shout out to Marty.
Where is it? Shout out to Marty. Yeah, hope you're doing well, buddy. Well,
that's it. I got a couple more coming. The Hardly Thin covers. They're the C2E2 variants. One of them's a Cubs. One of them's a Bears.
Really?
Yeah, it's that's pretty cool. Neat. Yeah, so that's nice. Those are on their way.
Okay, nice. Awesome. So we got 17 people still hanging out with us. It's a good Saturday night. I mean, Friday night. I mean, we're hanging out.
What are you talking about? There's 32.
Oh, all right. We're not refreshing.
There's 32. I just refreshed the screen right now. There's 32 people watching.
All right. We love it. So thank you very much for joining me on my birthday weekend.
Happy birthday.
Why I thought this was important was because we always get together. And for days like, you know, my mother, God rest her soul, always made birthdays very important. June is always my favorite month. So shout out to everybody who enjoys the month of June and looking forward to a great summer here, you know, whatever. So we got some other stuff to talk about. Justin, you have books too. I'm telling you, this is like a CGC, like, it's unbelievable.
That's all it is.
It's unbelievable. It's just stuff. Like, we just pure stuff and stuff and stuff. So what do you got for us?
Let's get our books.
All right, let's do it.
Good luck, guys. Good luck.
Yeah,
Justin. I hope that you bring this party up a notch with your grades.
All right, we got to turn this up, right?
Seriously, because... Yikes. Yikes. Holy shit.
Well, at least they're double sign.
Yeah, exactly.
Look, no, that's awesome. I really can't wait to look at them and check out the signatures. I really didn't even look at them.
Right, of course.
So, but I mean, just it was a 9.6, you guys. I do have a picture of it. So thank God I did that.
They're crooks. Yeah. The CGC secret sauce.
CGC crooks.
All right. So now, Justin, what's the story behind this book?
So this one is from Fantastic Comics on Instagram.
Okay, never heard of them.
Yeah, I just started following them.
Okay, shout out to
and
them.
Unfortunately, I can't afford a 9.8 on this book.
Yeah.
So we went with a 9.6 on this book. If I were to submit it. Well, unfortunately, I can't.
All right. So is this a modern book?
This is a modern book. All right. It's a book that I'm sure, like, once I show it off.
Variant?
No. It's a modern book. It looks like an 80s book. I'm sure once I show it off, you're going to be like, why don't I have it? I got a great deal on this book. So this is a 9.6 Transformers number 1.
Oh, my God.
9.6. Really? Yes.
You beat Optimus Prime?
CGC in 9.6 Transformers number 1.
Oh,
nice.
I can't afford a 9.8 because they're hitting like a G.
Are now. They really? They're up
they're
there.
Close. Yeah.
Why is there a price tag on there?
Yeah.
I have one of these at home.
Is there a price tag on it?
Price tag. Oh, 190 according to
him. We all know now.
According to what I got it for, it was less than that.
Really? That's a great book. That's a great price for that book.
Yeah. So
I'm a huge fan of that. That's Bill Segovich, right?
Yeah.
Segovich.
It's Kevich.
I didn't go anywhere near that for money.
White Pages. It's nice.
Why don't I have that book?
Because
I just haven't bought it yet.
Give it to him for his birthday.
Yeah, right. You're the best. All right. So I have this thing where I'm trying to collect all these books from like my youth, like Micronauts number 1 because it was a toy. G.I. Joe number 1, obviously because of the toys. The Transformers, the Grimlock, the first appearance of Dinobots, stuff like that. Those books, like, I'm just kind of getting like from 9.2s and 9.8s. But I think that's going to be. I think that might be the 9.8. Or the Masters of the Universe might be a 9.8. But if you're telling me that a 9.8 right now is hitting like 800, 900,
close to a G,
I don't know if I can do that. Yeah. That's unbelievable. That's just
like, I mean, it's
mine.
Yeah.
It's unbelievable. I mean, a 9.8 is hitting between $800 to $1,000.
Mine's
The 9.6, I got this for under $200.
Right. Tim, this is exactly what you were talking about, right? The discrepancies between the 9.8s and the 9.6s in the moderns. Yep. You know? Yeah,
huge, huge price drop. I mean, the best modern example would be ASM 301, simply because not only was it modern, but because it was a white cover and it was super thin. I mean, a 9.6 you probably get for like $200. A fucking 9.8 is $1,500 easily.
Yeah, right. It's crazy. It's crazy. Yeah. Shout out to you, bro. Good for you.
I take the 9.6.
I'll take a 9.6 too.
Well, when I mean like modern, I mean like the last 3 years. Like you buy it from your LCS and you submit it and it comes back a 9.6. That, I mean, you can get those all day long for like $20-$30.
And, right.
I mean, you're losing money on it because of the cost of shipping, basically.
Absolutely. All right. So good book. Congratulations. Nemesis Prime beat Autobus Prime.
That's the idea. Nemesis Prime. Got to have the Transformers one. I'm pretty sure I got a couple raw copies. If I submit,
I got a couple raw copies too.
If I submit to CGC and it comes back a 9.8, maybe this could be available to you. Just giving you a heads up. So the next book,
always.
So the next book is from Comic Sketch Art. Okay. This one was pre-screened and sold as a 9.8.
Right.
So this one is really cool. This was a convention exclusive. This one is a 9.8 Captain Marvel number one.
Really?
J. Scott Campbell, signed by J. Scott Campbell and his colorist, Sabine Rich.
Nice.
Really good book.
Dude, how about Worthy, dude? Look at the scene you're bringing down.
I mean, it's...
That is sick.
It's pretty awesome, right?
That is pretty
awesome. I mean, I bought this guaranteed to make sure it was a 9.8.
Also, I'd like to give a special shout out to Comic Sketch Art and give them a big fuck you. To them, because at WonderCon they wouldn't let me sit down against the wall because they said I was in line. So fuck off.
Oh, that's right.
Right,
was them. Yeah, because they were like, "Hey, if you're gonna be there, you need to get something signed by Snyder and Capullo." And I was like, "Dude, the end of the line is over there. I am not moving. Fuck off. I don't." Right. And then at that point, I just got mad. And I told him DC sucks. So,
but dude, that is a fat, fat book.
Yeah,
that is dope. I've never even seen that. Like,
yeah. They did, you know, this was exclusive to J. Scott Campbell's store. The convention exclusive was cover F. Right on the back, they got all the different covers. So, with this one with her her helmet and the hair coming right through it.
Yeah,
so,
for fabulous.
Fabulous.
Yeah, fabulous. Barry Gary saying yes for Micronauts number one. You know, Barry Gary's.
I got five copies of Micronauts number one.
Yeah.
All
right, so, awesome.
This is an awesome book. And the last book to go through is a CGC unboxing. Roger, do you want to come back here and do the unboxing by yourself?
You want me to touch it? Are you sure?
Now it's a party.
Okay. But I don't know.
What you guys do behind the counter is your own business.
So Roger's going to unbox this book. This is a, let me explain this book. This was a Awesome Con Washington, D.C. pickup back in March. This is a, what is it, White Widow number one. A variant by Ryan Kincaid. He's, you know, semi, I guess, what would you say? Zenoscope artist and also just, you know, I've got a couple sketches from him. So I don't know the grade, but he had his own sketch. It's a cover homage to, cover swipe to Spider-Man, Amazing Spider-Man. I want to say 667, 668. It's from the Spider Island universe.
Okay.
So I don't know the grade, but we're going to look at it.
All right.
You submitted this raw?
I submitted this raw completely. It was the only book I bought from the show. It was the only book that I submitted through CGC. Yeah. So, Roger, what do we got?
Roger, what is he dropping? What, right, what are we dropping?
What are we
dropping?
Oh, we got a 9.8.
Nice. Congratulations.
Just rub it in Ryan's face.
I know. Roger, well, you know what? To be fair.
Come on. Show it to the people.
Look at that.
Show it to the people.
That is dope.
Whoops.
I'm going to retire from comics at this point, I think, you guys.
Yeah.
This is the last you'll see of Dark
Side. You and Roger are going to go on like the Land of Lost Toys. That is
seriously.
CBCS so, all the way, baby.
Yeah.
Book, I don't know if you
PGX,
guys.
PGX.
Yeah. PGX.
This book, I can't say it has like the red is like foil.
That's
it's foil. And that is just absolutely
putting
sick.
The foil on.
God damn.
Ryan is like, yeah, he's ever seen My Cousin Vinny?
Yeah, right.
He has that old black lady on the stand, and she says she saw them drive away, and he comes back closer, and he goes, "Honey, I think maybe it's time you get upgraded your glasses. I think Ryan maybe needs to upgrade his glasses so he can see the you know the
I can see the 9.6 on the friggin' label.
Yeah,
on the blue label. Ugh, this is heartbreaking.
Just don't trust old dudes anymore, man.
Yeah, I know. We're just all like I got the readers on and stuff.
But
like
hey,
that,
so. You know what? To make up for it. I do have this beautiful Alex Ross 9.8 Detective Comics 1000.
You definitely do. Show that off a little bit.
All right.
That motherfucker.
There you go.
Yeah, that is good. That is good.
You know. So
I would like to say we speculated on that, but it wasn't public, so I guess it doesn't count. No. I can show you guys the screenshots when it first came out. I was like, man, I'm going to get this. And everybody, Ryan got it, and I forgot to buy it. And then by the time it came a $1,000 book, I was like,
yep, I got it. Yeah, and then I missed out on it. And that's definitely buyer's remorse. So I'm definitely, you know, sucking it on that one, seeing whatever. Plus, it's a great cover. I'm an Alex Ross fan, so, you know, that sucks. All right.
I should have bought that. I was going to buy two of them fuckers, too.
I know.
Because he was buying, what, they were 9.8 slab for, like, what, 200?
Okay, so I bought the deal. It was I don't know. It's the one back. You can't see it, but it's the one right. Where he's kind of standing like this, the profile, I guess you would call it.
Yeah, yeah. Yep.
And then it was this one, both guaranteed slab, 9.8 yellow label.
Right.
For 400. So essentially 200 a book.
Okay. So I don't get to do fucking show and tell. What the fuck, man?
Yeah, what do you? I know. Well, that's what happened. So
well, I've already showed all my shit, but I will show you this, man. Here. This is.
You just dropped a big video.
This is this one I just got, and this is a super hot book right now.
Okay.
This is War of the Realms, the new Agents of Atlas, number one. This is the Miko Siyuan variant. This features at least three first new appearances. It's Wave, Luna, and Swordmaster. Swordmaster and Luna were Chinese made for they were for first appearances in the comic, but they were Chinese characters that were made in a Chinese media company. In other words, they were in like some kind of graphic online comic book thing.
Right.
Marvel decided to put them in a comic. So the New Agents of Atlas is like the Asian team of superheroes, and Wave is the first ever Filipina superhero. And this book is blown up. It's about raw. It's about a $130 book.
Is right it now. Really?
Yeah, it's hot. All the printings have gone to. They've all gone to second prints. Greg Pak is the right. artist that's working on it. And
What are her powers?
I have no idea. I haven't even opened it yet. But Luna is coming out with their own solo series coming out soon. Greg Pak is going to be doing the writing or art on it. And that's coming up soon, actually. Luna and Swordmaster both have their own. I would imagine Wave is going to have their own first solo. And Shang-Chi is in this, too. So remember, we told you guys that they're talking about these characters to be in the Shang-Chi sequel, not the first movie, because they're auditioning a lot of Asian actors for the new Agents of Atlas. So, you know, you got a whole goddamn continent. First of all, the whole island of the Philippines, this book is blown up. Like, it's because it's a Filipino artist, Miko Siyuan. I think it's how you say his name. First ever Filipino superhero. So, and you know, the comic book industry has tons of Filipino cats, Carlos Pacheco. I mean, if you go down the line, a lot of these guys, artists, variant artists and internal artists, Wills Portacio, Filipino, right?
Yes.
What's his name? Ron Lim, Filipino.
Ron Lim, right.
Absolutely. Dude, they have a long lineage of Filipino artists and writers. Well, mostly artists in comic books. So that's why this book is so popular, man. Issue one and two have already gone to second printing. Issue three is coming out. That's already gone to second printing. If you follow Greg Pak, he talks about it. So it's a tough book to find.
Greg Pak, it's Rificon or something like that. He's a nice guy.
And the reason why this one's hot, because it has the actual Filipino flag on it and her on the cover. The first one doesn't have her on the cover, I don't think. That's dope. And who would have thought War of the Realms spinoff book would be hot, but it's just one of those things.
Well, that's it. That's where you got to jump in on it. So talk about
the shout out to Barry Gary, too, who bought 10 of them.
That's what I was going to say. He said he went hard on it. So maybe he'll disperse it to the group, you know, before it sends him off to CGC. Tigo, let's talk about the banger that you just picked up raw, sent it in, and what it came back at. Like, so it's a banger. It's FF49, right?
Oh, shit. Yeah, let me grab that motherfucker.
Yeah, this is a good book. This is unbelievable. I want to get – this is what I'm hoping for with, like, my Tomb of Dracula 10. So we'll talk about
that. I kind of have a lot of them. Yeah. If I would have known it was show and tell for Otto's birthday, I wouldn't have done a video first. But you can see my stack right here.
Look at that.
I've already did a video. But, I mean, this is the one that I bought raw. And remember, I was getting impressed. And I go, you know what? I think it'll hit a 7.0. If the grading gods were kind, I would get a 7.5. And I was able to hit a 7.5 on the first appearance of Galactus. So I won't lie, I paid about $650, $700 for it.
Okay.
This is about a $1,300, $1,400 book now.
Yeah, I agree with that. Nice.
When the news drops, it will even go out bigger. Fucking, yeah. I was looking, I have FF48. I was looking for FF50, and that's always been a cheap book. I just saw that book go for over $1,000 now. So FF50 is now picking up steam as well. But I was super stoked. This is a keeper to go. You have to bookend this one with FF48.
Right, absolutely. Yeah. I'm working mine up. I think 7.5 is ideal for 48 and 49. At least.
Good luck, man. Yeah, I was aiming for a 7.0 to, because I would like to be them, this came back a little bit higher. Like, if it came back a 5, you put it up to my FF48 to 7.0, I would have been like, kind of anal that way. But I got a bunch of other stuff already. Showed.
Anal. You like anal?
Hey, one finger, you're okay. Two fingers, you're gay. That's what I did. Here's one that I want to talk about. That I was a bit scared about getting it back because this is one of those modern books, right? So I got sent this into WonderCon. Nice. It was a CBCS 9.8, old label CBCS. Nice. So I was like, fuck. And Jim Chung was at WonderCon. I was like, I want to get this graded. So I went to our buddy Rocket Comics. Sorry, Ryan. But came back a 9.8 and signed by Jim Chung. First appearance of the Young Avengers, Wiccan, Kate Bishop, all that.
Kate Bishop. You've been talking about that book for 2 months.
Yeah, this is the Wizard World variant, and
that's the one you want, right, Tim?
This is the sketch variant that's hard to find. And guess what? Wizard World doesn't even fucking exist anymore, right? They had like one show back when Wizard World was in L.A. This is the sketch variant. The regular cover is all color. This is the sketch variant, and it has the Wizard World logo at the bottom, so it's a bit more rare. So I'm stoked that it came. I was worried. That was one of the ones where like, man. If I crack it at CBCS, it's the old label. I've had it for a long time. You never know what happens to a book when it's, even if it's slabbed, right? It's still can deteriorate. So on a modern book, I'm not worried, but I have a Strange Tales 110, 5.5.
Yeah.
I'm not ever cracking that from the
grade. Right.
It's stuck in that time for, that grade forever, as long as I keep it that way.
So. No, I agree. I go back and forth with some of my keys, but Roger and I kind of joke about the last time we met Neil Adams, and you just give him the book and he just puts his paw right on it.
My God.
And you can see talk about that.
Yeah. Bro, he read my damn book when I gave it to him.
Yeah, yeah. Listen, I want you to sign it, but I don't want you to put your big meaty paw on the freaking spine and bend the thing at the staples.
Right.
Now that book's useless.
Right. They're just killing you, digging you in that, right?
So what he did was I was like, hey, this is the Neil Adams Deadly Hands of Kung Fu magazine that has Bruce Lee in the cover.
Yep.
I was like, hey, can you sign this? And he signed it, and I was about to take it back, and he goes, man, I like this book. And he starts going through the pages. Yeah. I'm like, wow, you're fucking killing me, Neil. I mean, normally he's kind of like grumpy old get off my lawn.
Give me my money and get the hell out of here.
No, but he was like, I really like this one. I did a good job on this, didn't I? I was like, I was getting all nervous and shit. I'm counting the grades down as he's flipping through it.
Yeah, right. Counting the grades down. That's good. All right. So nice. So we got some good books. You got some bangers. I got a few books, right? I got two books that I'll talk about. Right. Roger, you want to get this for me? I got a book from CGC that came from C2E2. Yep, we're going to do that one last. We're going to do that one second.
This?
Yep, this is a cool book. This is an X-Men book.
You didn't even open it yet.
I didn't. That's your job. Prep it. Your job. So this book, my boy, shout out to Stevie Steeles on Instagram, another East Coaster, was selling some books. And I'm an X-Men fan.
Tape for free.
And, there's certain books that I don't need, and 9.2s and 9.8s. Sure, I'd love 9.8s, but you guys know I'm a numbers guy. 9.2s I like, 8.5s, 7.5s, somewhere in between that, 5.0s if it's a big book, or whatever you can get at realistic. 3.5s is the key. So I saw this book. That is a two-part book, and this is probably my second favorite. You packed the hell out of this, huh? Don't break a sweat. Cheers, everybody. Cheers. If you're having something to drink right now, hanging out while Roger's working.
You still had these. Cheers. I would have taken them out.
Cheers. So, absolutely. Thank you for joining us on my birthday weekend. All right. So, this book, I know the grade. It's Days of Future Past, number 2. All right, 142. All right. And it's an 8.5. And this is just a great, great book because I don't have it slabbed. I have it raw. But 141 and 142 are very, very iconic books in the X-Men. Mythos, which how are we saying it, Tim?
Mythos,
right? Mythos. So, for what the book is worth and what it was slabbed, it was a great deal. So, shout out to Stevie Steeles on IG. Now, I'm going to find 141 in an A5, right?
Of course.
Of course. I mean, you got it. Without a doubt. But unbelievable. And that's a classic X-Men cover with it's the future Old Man Logan, which I like to think it was the first appearance of Old Man Logan. You know, everybody's either deceased or captured, and Wolverine, there's nothing on Wolverine's name, so it's classic. And I really thought Days of Future Past was decent. Maybe we'll talk about Dark Phoenix. I don't know what Rotten Tomatoes is giving it. I don't know if it's getting killed.
27%, I think, last time. Right.
Yeah.
I've seen people say it's the worst thing they could have done to wrap up the story.
And then what else?
But you know what? You had the same kind of bullcrap with Endgame. And,
yep.
I mean,
all right.
I don't know.
I mean, I think every X-Men movie, the last part, like X-Men Last Stand, the next Dark Phoenix.
So the audience score on Dark Phoenix is 64. So.
Okay. All right.
I'm seeing it tomorrow. So
my next question. When are you seeing it? Tomorrow?
I'm seeing it tomorrow afternoon.
Sunday.
Yeah, I'm sure we'll all get to it by the end.
Right.
By Wednesday, we'll have at least
we'll get to it.
The only reason I'm hesitant on it because Simon Kinberg is the writer. First time director. So Simon Kinberg, up to that point, he's basically written movies, screenplays. I mean, he co-wrote Fantastic Four for what it is, but he's also done some other stuff. But you know, that's why anytime you get a first time director, you get a little scared. You know what I'm saying? So so that's why let me see if we have time.
Yeah, I was gonna say what I think is pretty cool is the fact that in the previews they go out in space. And that was straight out of X-Men, you know, 97, 98, 99.
Put it this way. The only thing he's ever directed is an episode of The Twilight Zone.
Oh, God. Okay. All right. Well, we'll have to see what happens. But anyway, I'm sure we'll come back as either Three Men in the Basement or The Lords and talk about it. All right. So now, this is a book that as a kid, I coveted. Okay. This is Giant Size X-Men number one. Okay.
Oh, this is the one.
This is it. All right. So this is Giant Size X-Men number one. This was sent to at C2E2. I bought this on eBay years ago before I got back into Instagram and before I started collecting. My rebirth with comics kind of came through Instagram and it would all kind of happen at the same time. So this was a book that I bought raw. I had Shaver press it. Chris Shaver on Instagram, shout out to him. And it came back.
C Shaver 00.
Yep, C Shaver 00. Check him out. He's a very good presser. All the pressers we've been using have just been fantastic. So, you know, don't have a bad thing to say about any of them. I probably used all five of them, including Ryan when he was working, man. But he's retired.
Yeah, that shit was too stressful.
Okay. So this is Giant Size X-Men number one. I had Chris Claremont sign it. Chris Claremont did not write this book. Len Wein did, who died. Dave Cockrum did the art. So why did I have Chris Claremont sign it? Because I don't have anything signed by Claremont yet in the slab. Okay. But I also know that when we all know what Claremont did with the X-Men, right? He carried them for everything. He wrote everything. And this was actually the beginning of the genesis of all this, how Giant Size X-Men number one. But I read, and I believe this is factually correct, that, you know, when these guys were in a bullpen, they were sitting right next to each other. So there was a story about how Len Wein didn't know how to wrap the story up as far as kill the island of Krakoa, the creature, or stuff like that. And Claremont gave him the answer. Claremont says, you need to do this. You need to use Storm's power for here. You need to do this. You need
Spoiler alert.
Right. Well, I don't even know how old the book is. So I had Claremont sign it. And it was a 6.5. I'm absolutely ecstatic if it comes back a 6.5. If it hits a 7, I'm really, really psyched. If it comes back a 6, I'm not too happy. But again, it is my book. It has I'm not going to trade it. I've seen this book climb up. You know, X-Men 94 and Giant Size X-Men have been creeping up. So, Roger, without further ado. So
this book is in worse shape than my first Morbius.
Oh, here we go. Oh, here we go. Bitter grapes. So what am I looking at? A 7-0! Yes!
Nice.
Oh, here we go.
Oh, that's nice.
Happy birthday, Otto. Happy birthday,
buddy. That's a great birthday present right there. That is a great birthday present. That's a great bump. Shout out to Shaver and Rocket for pressing it. Coming back, and it's a square bound book, right, Tim? So those books are
pain in the ass. I had an 8.5. I got Chris Claremont to sign it, and it came back a 8.0. But
I had a
stolen 9.2.
Did you? Oh, that's right. Oh my god.
Ryan has the worst luck ever.
No. Listen, okay. Let's talk about. I'm sorry to interrupt this program. Let's have a story time.
Oh, that's okay. Not a great story.
Let's have
a
story time. Story.
So, anyway, hey Otto, your GPA on the last sale in that book was 2250.
Was it really?
In the 7.0.
Oh, so dude,
a low sale is 1600. Average sale is 1878. But a last one sold for 25. Good Lord. 7.0 is high sales, 2250. So your average sale is 1800 on 7.0, which ain't too bad. God,
and I paid.
The last sale is 1675.
Right. Oh, my God. That's
so you awesome. add the signature onto it, bump it up, you know, maybe 100, 200 bucks.
Yeah, right. Tight signature, clear my signature.
I'll Before tell you, Ryan continues his story, my giant size X-Men was in Stan Lee's hands when he died.
Oh, Jesus.
Sorry to be a bummer. But no, what?
Right.
Well, it was part of the stack of books that were waiting to get signed by Stan Lee, and he passed away, and I was going to get him signed by Stan Lee and Chris Claremont. And I only got Chris Claremont's signature, and Stan Lee passed away while my books were in his possession. So, sorry.
Well, maybe you have skin flakes from the apartment.
Yeah, right.
I believe you can buy his blood again.
Story about your giant size X-Men.
Okay, well, I'm going to give you two stories because I want you guys to know why. I get comments sometimes. You know, Darkseid Jedi looks like he's grumpy or he's upset. You're gonna see why.
This is your Lord of the Frog by Three Men in the Basement twin.
You guys are like twinning. This is why you're gonna see why. Okay, so it all started with Justice League of America number one, 1960.
Book in the worst way.
I bought it raw. It was gorgeous. Now, I'm not educated on restoration. I'm not educated on
just put
grade.
The period on not educated.
I'm not educated. There exactly. Bought it raw, $2,500, because I thought, and the dealer said, it looked like a seven. It looked like a seven all day long. I scrutinized. I would be blown away if it came back a six. I would have been upset. So send it in CGC. It comes back restored 6.5.
Oh, kiss of death.
Okay. Ooh. So
then the Justice League movie came out and fucking tanked, and the DC universe.
Three trimmed edges.
Trimmed. Oh,
three trimmed edges.
Wow. So normally you want trim, but not in this case.
So there was there was no taking. I ended up selling it for $650 to a friend.
Really?
Damn. Yep. Second story. This is the The Action Comics 252 or 240. Which one is the Brainiac? 242 or 252?
Oh, okay. I remember this story.
So 242.
So Brian, how many years ago with this? Because this is how long
this. Yeah, this was. Man, I want to say 3 or 4 years ago.
Yeah, it was quite some time.
Yep, 3 or 4 years ago. So I had a dealer friend, come over. He introduced me to this guy that was buying books. So I ended up selling a bunch of books to him, and I kind of rolled it over into two bigger books. So I bought a 9.2 GSX number one, and I bought a 5.5. Action 242.
Gotcha.
First Brainiac,
which is an unbelievable.
Yeah, gorgeous. It was gorgeous.
Talking about that. That's Brainiac.
And I got it.
Andor. I mean, that's classic DC Legion of Doom stuff.
And at the time, I got it for a steal. Both of them. It was a good deal.
Okay.
So I ended up selling the GSX one, and did well. So that's the good part of the story.
Yeah.
Silver linings, everybody. There's always silver linings. You will find the one thing I find about this hobby is that it kind of always has a way of balancing itself out.
Agreed.
You know what I mean? So you're going to get shit on, but you're going to find some good deals. Well, don't get me wrong.
Gonna be great,
oh, I got it.
Your
uptake
is going to be. You're going to explode, bro. You're just going to explode.
So
the rest of the year.
So then I put the Action 242 on eBay. I'm thinking I'm going to get, you know, maybe. Three or four. I don't know. I'm thinking. I get a call from a detective in Indianapolis.
Oh my gosh.
Oh,
this is Detective So and So. I just want to let you know that a book that you posted on your eBay page is stolen, and the owner saw it and contacted us and wants to know if, you know, he can get it back.
Get out of here.
Yep. So now I don't know what the laws are.
No, of course, right?
Oh, right, of course. But at the end of the day, now it's owner's possession, obviously.
Right.
At the end of the day, he offered me $2,500 for it.
Oh my gosh.
I wanted 35 or 4. I mean, right. but realistically, I had it at best offer.
Gotcha.
2,500 was around GPA at the time.
Yep.
So I was like, you know what? Comic karma. I'll give the guy his book back. I got $2,500 for it. So at the end of the day, it wasn't a bad deal, but it was not a good deal.
No. That's unbelievable.
Well, those are my experiences with comics. Oh, and then, never mind. That wasn't really one. It was a raw Red Hood Lost Days number one. I bought it raw.
Oh, that's a Matina cover, right?
Yeah, it was real hot. I bought it raw.
Oh, dude, I'm after that book.
And it looked like it was high nines, like 9.4 or maybe 9.6.
Yeah.
Obviously hoping 9.8, but pipe dream. Came back in 9.0. So that was another disappointment.
Stupid CGC.
So you know what? Yeah, seriously. Damn it. PGX.
PGX, right? All the way, all the way. Right. So there's one thing I want to talk about. So we've got, you know, we still got like 25 people hanging out with us, 20 people. Our boy Dave Davis or 9.8 here, Comics with Supplane is with us. Great Lakes Paddle Club. All right. That's great. I love that name. Mastodon Comics and Collecting. Let's talk about a book that, because I have really buyer's remorse right now, okay? I absolutely have buyer's remorse with my Tomb of Dracula 10 9.0. I wanted to sell this book so bad. White Pages, I sold it. I didn't get it, but it was worth it. I got a Spider-Man minor villain key, which I thought was around it. But now with all the talk about Blade, I need to get another copy, right? So I have total buyer's remorse about this book. So that's one book that I have buyer's remorse about. So
buyer's remorse or seller's
remorse? Seller's remorse. I apologize. Seller's remorse. So what about you?
No.
Nothing? You sell everything?
No, maybe the first Black Cat I sold. Okay. I bought from PJ and then I turned it around. I don't think I'm going to get it.
Right. So, okay.
But am I going to get that 9.0 at that price?
All right. Justin, seller's remorse for you, any of your books lately?
I agree with Roger. I mean, my Black Cat won. I mean, have a 9.6 that I won in a raffle, but I had an 8, like a 7 or an 8.0 CGC that I sold. I mean, now these books are so hot. I mean, like, I wish I would have kept on.
Held on to it
for a longer time.
Right, right. Ryan, do you have any seller's remorse with any books in your collection?
I have nothing but seller's remorse. I am a DC heavy collector.
Yeah.
But I had a lot of Marvel as well.
Okay.
I've sold most of my Marvel, which is now blowing up. So I backed the wrong horse, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah, that's right. Tim, we're just talking about a book that maybe you might have a little buyer's remorse from.
Seller's remorse.
I can't see that. Seller's remorse. You know, I mean, any book that comes to mind real quick, mine is Tomb of Dracula 10.
Mine is because I am a modern flipper.
Like, yes.
I will buy variants and I will flip them every, because only, you know, what, 2 out of 10 will retain their value and go up in price.
Yeah.
But like, you know, Bronze Age stuff, you know, typically I break even or I'll make money.
Yeah.
The one that I had twice that I sold twice is What If Venom Possessed Deadpool?
Really?
I had it in a 9.8 book at one time. Then I had that and something else, and I flipped it. Or actually, I did a trade with somebody for ASM 129 8.5. Okay. I took the ASM 129 along with the X-Men 266 and flipped that for a Strange Tales 110. Wow. So that I'm not, you know, I got Stan Lee to sign the ASM 129. So I'm happy because I end up with a Strange Tales 110. So that's how I came out ahead on that by about a grand.
Yeah.
But then I got another. What a Venom Possessed Deadpool. I got that in the 9.8. I was lucky, signed by Scotty Young, and I ended up selling it for 600. I think it's like, it's easily like over a grand now.
Wow. That book.
This one I still regret, because this book is, I think, going to blow up, as the first Spider-Gwen Greg Land variant. I had that in the 9.8.
Oh, which one is that? 25?
It's the first appearance of it's like her with her mask off. She's kind of like posing sideways. Yeah. And so that's like the Edge of Spider-Verse number two.
I would have a course for that.
I just thought of the word.
One is uber hot and it's only going to get hotter. So I'm
and it's only a 1 in 25, but that was before kind of variants were popping, Justin.
Yeah. I sold that one for 500. I bought it for 200. And at the time I thought it was a good deal, but now it's like 50.
What's the flip on that right now? Like,
I remember buying that book, and I was upset when I was like, I had to pay $30 for that book. When it first came out, I was like, oh, $30. I was like, I'm not paying $30 for this. I was like, whatever, let me just buy it, and I get it. And then I snapped it up, came back at CBCS 9.8, and then the book jumped, and I was like, I'm happy as hell.
Right.
And then I cracked it. I had it pressed by CBCS.
Yeah.
I had it signed by Greg Land, and it came back at 9.6, and I was just like, okay. Whatever.
Right.
Oh, so boy. Whatever, 9.6 signed. And
yeah, great. That's books are hot.
For $30 and slap it in.
Yep.
Let me tell you what it is right now, just to make us all feel bad about it.
Yeah, right. Dude, actually,
$17.50, dude, in a 9.8 for that Greg Land. Wow. Edge of Spider-Verse number two, Greg Land variant, sold for $17.50.
Look this up for me. The biggest regret now that I'll be specific.
Easier said than done.
Yeah, I know. I stutter, man. Captain Britain. I had a Captain Britain number one.
Oh.
9.4.
Oh, really?
I bought it for $300.
The one from 1976, right?
The one, the British one or whatever. Yeah, the first appearance of it was a 9.4.
Yep. Oh, you're not gonna like this.
Yeah, that's a Lords of the Long Box hot book right there.
That's not so bad. No. 500 last sale. Not many of them go for sale. So let me look. If I look back 6 month data, I probably get more. It's right at 450, 500. But I would think now.
No, I sold it for three.
Oh, sorry.
But that book's going to jump.
But I sold it a year and a half ago or 2 years ago.
So in the last one that sold was, according, I'm using Comics MV, by the way. So the last sale was May 6th for 500.
But that news just came out, right? We were just talking about that.
Yeah, right. Hold on a second, though.
It's already out in the ether, so.
It's definitely out there. So I do have a few more books that I did pick up. I have a very Gary purchase. I have a Nemesis Prime purchase. So I'm going to show you too. This book is kind of my birthday present, right? This is my birthday present to me, you know, because it's my birthday and why not? So I bought this book off the rack. I've talked about this at length. When this book came out, I couldn't believe that they were actually writing a story about somebody being more worthy than Thor to wield a hammer, especially an alien, right? I just couldn't understand. Like when you're 14, 15 years old, and you're reading this, you're like, how can this happen? And this started the whole Walt Simonson run for me, right? With Better A Bill and Mjolnir, and with Stormbreaker. And I just can't believe how this book has jumped up. But right before it jumped up, Barry Gary gave me a great price, right? Said it, boom, bang. The next thing you know, somebody bought a bunch of 9.8s, and it almost doubled. And Barry Gary is such a righteous dude that he held to the same price. So shout out to you, Barry Gary. You're always a friend. And this is a book that I can't wait to display. All 330, Thor 337, first appearance of Better A Bill, and a 9.8. So
nice, absolutely
stoked to have this book. Never in my life did I think I'd pay what I paid for it. Never in my life did I think what it would be going for. But just a great, great book. Really,
did you have that graded or did you buy it?
No, Barry Gary did the work.
Okay.
So Gary did the work. Awesome. Mine, I have one or two copies, you know. 2 years ago, you could have found this, you know, in a $5 bin.
I have two raw copies.
Sending this for him now. I just gave it to him to send him my
copy. You are?
Yeah.
Oh, nice. Right. Absolutely. Yeah. You absolutely should. So that's a great book. And now I do have two more books. Now, this is linear as a day is long. This is Nemesis Prime. Now, I know what these books are going at a 9.8. These are moderns. These are moderns, but they're 9.4s. But why I think they're really cool is, one, Justin gave me a great price. Two, it's the regular and a variant, and it's a pretty hot character, and they're both 9.4s. So,
nice.
Teen Titans number 12.
Damn it, I'm jealous of those.
Yeah, of the Joker who Batman who laughs, who we talked about, and it's a regular and a variant, and they're both 9.4. You don't get more linear than this. This is exactly what it is.
It's actually impossible.
Yeah, I know. Like, more linear. You can't. So Justin was selling. I was like, oh, that's pretty cool. And then I'm like, oh, wait a minute. That's really cool. Like, that's both linear. So I'm pretty stoked about that.
Drink every time. If anybody's drinking with us, drink every time Otto says linear.
Linear. I said a lot of linear
and stuff like that.
I haven't said that a lot tonight. Cheers. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday. Yes, that's right. Everybody take a drink.
Sending this in.
If anybody's got them, drink them.
Absolutely. So we do lately, if you've been noticing on Lords of the Long Box, Tim Tebow and has a source, the Source Supreme. He has the Black Knight report. And we kind of talked a little bit about this, kind of speculating, but there was some FF news. And it's kind of here, it's kind of there. To me, I was kind of like, I kind of expect that, if that's what they're going to do. Tim, we've talked, we've heard about this. Now, do you think this is what they're going to do? Is the FF will be phase four and that the first villain will be Mole Man? Is that what you're hearing?
Yeah, I don't think it's phase four, but it's coming. Probably phase five, since they need some time for it. But, I mean, we broke it on 2 weeks ago, and then websites started reporting on it 2 days ago.
Tim, I got to ask you a question, buddy. What did you do to that guy on Twitter for him to go nuts trying to disclaim what your claims were?
You know what? I just end up giving up. Those people on the those twatters or whatever the fuck they're called. They stick to their thing of just clickbait. Twitter and their websites and whatever. But I'm like,
yeah, but you know the what? Proof that you told this story 2 weeks before that is there. There's it's nothing.
Exactly. So that's why I didn't bother arguing with them on Twitter. I'm like, look, man, we have, like the kids say, we got receipts, man. You know, it's the damn timestamp on the video, right? It's May 22nd. We reported Peyton Reed was going to be directing FF. And what I like to do is whenever they, you know, he shut up after I even gave more details, and I was like, all right, well, I'm also hearing Emily Blunt is in talks to play Sue Storm, and David Harbour is in talks to play The Thing. David Harbour, of course, is the new Hellboy, and we know they ain't making a sequel for that.
No.
And people are saying it's the Black Knight is going to be in it. No, it's not going to be Black Knight. It's not the Quantum Realm. They're going old school. It's going to be the Mole Man.
Yeah.
And Galactus is going to be teased. He's going to be the next Thanos. So you're not going to see him, but you know how Thanos was first teased and end credit scene, and Dr. Doom's going to be lurking. So they're Feige knows this is classic FF. Why the fuck would they deviate and talk about the Quantum Realm and the Black Knight? No, they got the Mole Man, they got the Negative Zone, they're going to do Annihilus, they're going to do Dr. Doom, and it's all going to lead eventually to Galactus as the big bad baddie. So there you go. You can add that, put it on your pipe and smoke it, MCU.
Timestamp. Hey, first of all, I want to know a timestamp. It is 10:11 p.m.
I'll tweet that out to your buddy.
So I even sent it to CBR, Comic Book Resources, and they said, oh, we're comfortable with our own sources. I like, okay, go ahead and run that story that they're going to be using the Black Knight.
I like is put in the work, write a blog. No, dude, we're doing it live on YouTube, telling everyone, like
if they could probably, you know, speak on camera. MCU Cosmic does have a YouTube channel, but they have like 7,000 subs and they get like 400 views a video.
Probably half.
He says he used to work for IGN and all this other stuff, but I mean, you know, it's, you know, our source basically is the same sources that they get. If anything, our source gets it directly, and what it is our source basically got a cease and desist letter before, because he was supposed to get on his Facebook. So now the reason we even got this source is because we basically speculated there was a secret
of all, hold on. Tell this. You have to tell this story because it's not something to brush over. You, on a Lords of the Longbox show, said blatantly, I believe that there is a secret cabal that drives up prices of comics. When no one else knows, because all of a sudden, I mean, come on.
We like, on the
Illuminati was found out, and the Illuminati contacted
me. Ryan, Justin, and Otto have a private Instagram and Facebook group where I can tell them stuff that we're going to talk about. And I was like, and I've said this on our show a lot of times. I was like, look, there's secret forces at work that drive up the prices on books before there's any news. And you guys know these books because you're wondering why are these prices going up. Sometimes it's not the right news, like She-Hulk. That book went up for no reason at all because there is no She-Hulk news, right? So people got it wrong. But Nova, Captain Marvel, all these things, and then next thing you know, it started happening. Shang-Chi, right? All these books started going up in price, and then next thing you know, they became movies. So I've said it a few times, but that's what I guess. And then he happened to watch our show, and he sent me a private message on Instagram saying, hey, you know what? You're dead on about that. We have a group of, I have a private Facebook group, and I tell them news, and we all go buy the comics, but we don't make it public. Right. And that's smart, right? Why would you? Right. So they go and buy up all the books. And so they were buying, they bought Shang-Chi back in 2015. They were buying it up. They bought Captain Marvel three or four years ago, right? Before Brie Larson was announced.
Yeah.
And so he goes, "You're spot on, dude. That's what we do." And I cultivated a relation with them. And I was like, "Hey, man." And he has his own business on the side. So he doesn't do it for the money. You know what I'm saying? He's not doing it like these other sites that do it for clicks and advertising and whatever to get like us. We all have full-time jobs and I just give out the news freely because he said, "You know what? Hey, man, tell your viewers so they can also take advantage of this and buy up those books too." And so, you know, it's not always going to be 100% accurate because guess what? Shit changes. People's schedules change, you know, screens, things change, but things like, you know, who knows what's going to happen, but FF is coming. Peyton Reed is doing it. So it was just kind of cool because the work that we were putting in finally got recognized because there is a secret cable, you know,
pretty sweet
collectors. And I think it starts in CGC forums and it starts in private Facebook groups.
Yeah, definitely.
But this is the thing. You have integrity. We have integrity. We speak. We're not always right. And we will come out and we will say that we're not right if we're not right.
Right.
But because of the integrity, because of the research that Tim actually puts in, you know, you get the recollection and it's really nice. Well,
if I get something, I just don't buy the recollection. I try to at least try to find other resources for it. You know what? Let me put two and two together. This makes sense.
You can't be like some of these other Twitter pages that just say shit.
Like Grace Randolph, you mean?
There you go.
We were talking about this today between Justin to myself, like, I don't mess with Twitter. There's the negativities out there. I tell you, Instagram is the way to go. Everybody's positive, upbeat. You know, Facebook, everybody's Facebook. You make something on Facebook and they're like, "Oh, why would you say that? Do you ever know?" Like, I don't know, dude.
Yeah, Twitter is just made for divisiveness. It's just people who just want to argue. That's why it's like I tweet every now and then, but for the most part we'll go on YouTube because, you know, our live chat is full of our friends or followers, and this way most of the people in there talk to each other. And
yeah.
But, you know, like we were talking about offline, we're going to be doing our own top 10 list because it was recommended to me that we should. But our top 10 list is a little bit different.
Yeah.
It's a long-term spec list. So, believe it or not, there is a list that DC and Marvel uses, mostly Marvel. So it's called the secret cabal of collectors have called it a reserve list. So essentially, Kevin Feige puts hold on characters, meaning that he wants to use them. Kevin Feige is the main domino. That means whatever he doesn't put a hold on, Jeff and Marvel TV can use, right? So Kevin Feige says, "I want to use Daredevil." Feige says, "I don't have any plans for him. Go ahead." But Kevin Feige also says, "I have put this character on hold. No other Marvel properties are supposed to use them. And we will tell you soon who's on that list." So if Kevin Feige puts on hold, that means he wants to do something within the next 5 years, 6 years. Yeah. But that means Marvel Animation. That means more probably back in the day, Netflix couldn't use it. And that means now probably Hulu can't use it because Feige is everything he wants to be MCU is Disney Plus and probably Hulu. But he's putting a reserve on it because he doesn't also mean that even the comic books, hey, you might want to promote this or don't change this character too much or kill them off or something along those lines. Or bring him back from the dead like Wolverine and Fantastic Four because, you know, guess what? We're buying Fox now.
Right.
You know what I mean? Funny
because what we've been talking about, and I know in both of our chat groups, what book did we talk about today? Darkhawk number one, 9.8. Like, you know, I messaged some guy today. Hey, dude, what do you want for a copy of it?
Where did that come from, right? Where did that come from?
Yeah, exactly.
How did that book? Someone knows something, right?
Yeah, that book is – there's a lot of them for sale for some reason, man.
Right. So interesting. So it's funny the way the books come around and stuff like that. So, you know, I've showed some books. Roger showed some books. Justin showed some books. Tim showed some books. Man, it's been a great time, man. Thank you very much, everybody. Happy birthday. Thank you very much. Cheers. So I want to shout out King of the Golden State. He's been hanging out with us for a little while.
What up, James?
Javier Salas has been in the house. Geeky Swag Shot. What's up, my boy? Good to see you. Model Vault's been good. So we've got our winners. Matt24. Michael Rowe and BXPR Collector. Matt24, you're third place. Michael Rowe, you're second. BXPR Collector, you're our first place winner. Find me on Instagram, Everett_Otto. We've been kicking it here for almost 70 minutes right now, and it's been a good show, man. Yeah, we've got a lot of books, a lot of stuff to talk about. You know, so I'm going to sign off. I'm just going to give everybody a shout-out, man. Thank you very much for joining me. Really made my weekend start off awesome. Justin came up from Jersey. Roger made it a point to come down and get ready. Bernie 1869 is adulting. My brother's from the Lords. jumped on tonight. So thank you very much for that. I really appreciate it. Roger, any last words, my friend?
No, man. Thanks, everybody, for joining us. Thank you, Lords, for coming on here. Tim and Ryan, go blue.
All right.
Go Justin. Blue.
Yeah. Ryan, Tim, thank you for joining us on a Friday night. You know, and as always, we'll be live next Wednesday. So.
Variant spotlight dropping this weekend? You got a busy weekend. Not. You got a busy weekend, buddy.
Probably not.
Okay, so pass on. You got a patch. You
pass
pass.
This weekend, pass. But
right. Next Wednesday. Right. Dark Side Jedi, my boy. What can you say, brother? What do you got to sign off?
I'm going to go jump off the Ambassador Bridge with these CGC books tied to
you're
my
gonna
leg.
You're going to see slabs floating in the Erie Lake yeah. or wherever the fuck is near
right,
Detroit.
Ron, well,
that's the bridge from Detroit to Windsor,
we'll
Canada.
We'll come together.
You go through your support group.
All Ambassador Bridge.
Thank you very much for joining us tonight. I know it's early on the West Coast for you, but anything you want to say before we jump off tonight?
Nope. Happy birthday, man.
Thank you very much. I really appreciate that. So everybody in the live chat, thank you very much for enjoying my birthday with me. We've had books. We talked about books, comics, movies, all that stuff. This is exactly what Three Men in a Basement is for. That's exactly what we do here in the Grotto. So on behalf of Lords of the Long Box, on behalf of Three Men in a Basement, I am Otto, and I am out. Peace.
Peace, everybody.
Peace, everybody.
Go Big Blue.
Go Blue.